Now we move on to the third problem on projectile motion. In the third problem, we have a particle which has been projected with initial velocity u at an angle theta, and we are asked to find the time at which the velocity is perpendicular to the initial velocity. That is, the instant of time t at which the velocity v is, if it is in this direction, these two vectors are at 90 degrees to each other. What that means is, the dot product of these two vectors should be equal to 0. We have to find the time. Now, the initial velocity vector is given by u cos theta times I plus u sin theta times j. Right? The final velocity vector v is given by u cos theta, since the horizontal velocity is constant, plus u sin theta minus jt. Now, if I take the cross product of this dot product of these two vectors, that should be equal to 0, since the two velocity vectors are perpendicular to each other. Okay, let's take the dot product. The dot product will be given by u square cos square theta plus u sin theta minus gt. This should be equal to 0, or I could write u square cos square theta plus sin square theta is 1 plus that now minus u sin theta gt equal to 0, or time t equals to u by g sin theta. So at this instant of time, the two velocity vectors are perpendicular. So this was our third problem. Now before moving on to the fourth problem, now let's recapitulate what we have learned till now. Till now, we have discussed the assumptions which we make while solving problems on projectile motion. Next, for a projectile projected from a horizontal surface, we have derived the expression for the time of flight, the range, maximum vertical distance covered. The time of flight was given by 2u sin theta by g, where u was the initial velocity vector and theta was the angle the velocity vector made with the horizontal. The range was given by u square sin 2 theta by g, and the maximum vertical height was given by u square sin square theta by 2g. The relation between r, h and theta was tan theta equals to 4h by r. The equation of the trajectory of the path followed by the projectile was given by y equals to x tan theta minus g by 2. Minus g by 2 into x square by u square cos square theta. This was the equation of trajectory of the projectile. This equation of trajectory could have been simplified as x tan theta 1 minus x by r. These were the equations which we had already derived, and for solving any problem of projectile motion, it's not required to know these equations, but because you can always solve the problem using basic equations of kinematics, but it's better to remember this formula. Now let's move on to the fourth problem. The fourth problem is a particle is projected with angle alpha from the horizontal. At an instant of time t, the angle of elevation of the particle is beta. So, in the question, we are asked to find the initial velocity of the particle. So the question is, particle is projected with alpha angle from the horizontal. At time t, the angle of elevation of the particle is beta, and we are asked to find the initial velocity of the particle. So the particle will follow the projectile path as shown here. It's said that it is projected at an angle alpha, and at some instant of time t, it makes an angle beta with the horizontal. So the angle of elevation is beta. This is the displacement of the particle at that instant, which is y. This is the horizontal displacement, which is x. Now x can be written as ux into t, where ux is the initial velocity. Which in this case will be u cos alpha into t, where I have assumed the initial velocity to be u. Similarly, the y displacement can be written as u y t minus g t, where u y is the initial velocity in the vertical direction, which is u sin alpha in this case. This will be u y t minus half g t square. This is the equation of motion for a uniformly accelerated particle. So this is u sin alpha t minus half g t square. Now from the figure I know that tan of beta is y by x, right? So equating these two, I will get tan of beta equals to sin alpha u sin alpha t minus half g t square by u cos alpha t. This will get simplified as u sin alpha minus half g t by u cos alpha. So this I can write as tan alpha minus a little bit t gt by u cos alpha. So from this equation I can easily find u. So finally I'll get u as gt by 2 cos alpha tan alpha minus tan beta. This is the answer. Okay. So this question involved knowing only the basic equation of kinematics. Now let's move on to the fifth problem.